Instagrammed cake in our nation, the strawberry watermelon cake. How good does it look? There it is. There is a slice of it, and here it is in real life. Others have tried to copy the famous dessert, and they're pretty good, but why try when you can just buy? Creator, the lovely Christopher from the Black Star Pastry, joins us now to show us how it is done.
Hello.
Christopher, welcome.
Welcome.
This looks extraordinary. How easy is it?
Look, I'm going to do one here right now.
Okay.
I'm going to make it look as easy as I can, but it is quite difficult because...
Right. Fiddly. Looks fiddly.
Yeah.
So what do we do?
What do you do?
Yeah.
Firstly, we've got this chocolate dacquoise. And I have to say, this is a version we're doing for the Smooth FM Chocolate Festival.
Which starts when?
On the 10th and 11th of September.
Great.
Right, only available then, so the white chocolate... is in the mousse, and you'll see this different garnish up
you
here.
Say a dacquoise.
Dacquoise.
What's that? Oh!
That's okay, because you'll just see it'll go in. Dacquoise is a meringue with almond meal through it.
Oh.
But you see, this one's a chocolate one.
Okay. So how do we...
Here we go, look.
Oh, that's it.
Yeah.
So what do we put on top of the dacquoise?
This one has just painted chocolate, right? Just to give it that extra little bitterness on top, so that also keeps it together there.
Okay.
Let me move this guy over here.
And this is your watermelon. How do you get it that perfect? As in, so you use one of these?
Yeah. Trade secret.
What is that? Is that a...
like a cake tin thing?
It's like a cake ring, right?
Yeah.
And if you don't have that, you can do it with just the spring form tins that you have at home.
Oh, sure.
But or a saucepan lid?
Ooh.
Why not cut it out?
Yeah, okay. You know, the little trick we've got is this piece of acetate, okay, and that'll just go in. You can buy that at, like, art shops, right? Should be pretty straightforward.
Or Glad Wrap?
Or Glad Wrap, yes, you could use that at a pinch.
Mm-hmm.
You could also just use paper if you got that, okay? Okay, so that's the first level.
And then do we put the watermelon in?
Almost. We've got...
Almost.
Oh, right down here, I've got the cream.
Oh.
Also,
that's just normal cream?
Well, it is rose-scented cream. So we have a beautiful rose water.
Mm-hmm.
Comes from Iran, right?
And you mix that with the cream?
Yeah.
Can you buy this?
This is just a little piping bag, but no, what you need to do is go online to paria.com and then you can buy their rose water, or you can just go to a deli. But you've just got to be careful not to buy a cheap one, because you'll end up with a cake that just tastes like...
not good.
Like shampoo.
Why do you think this cake is so popular?
I think it's so popular because it just looks delicious.
Mm.
You can tell what it's going to taste like just by looking at it. Right.
And what's the inspiration behind it?
It was a wedding cake.
Really?
Oh, yeah. It was very early on. I mean...
Do we put this in here?
Go for it. Have a go. Gee, look at that.
Wow, Jess.
It should just slide straight in. There we go. Well done.
All right.
Oh,
let me get that little bit of plastic up.
Oopsie.
That's okay.
And then you put the cream over the top again. Would that be right?
That's right. Here we go.
Oh, look at you. Now, this Smooth FM Chocolate Festival,
that
is my idea of heaven.
It's a great day. We did it last year. The sun was out. It's on Sydney Harbour at the Rocks. It's really beautiful.
So all different types of sweet treats to sample and...
Yep, you betcha. And I'm doing this demo, so you can come meet me there on the Sunday. So it's the 10th and 11th of September.
And of course,
in Sydney.
You are at the wonderful Black Star.
Yes, that's my shop.
Which because I have the biggest sweet tooth, and I do love coming in to see what sweet treats you've got there. Oh, now do we have another layer?
We do. So this one.
Another dacquoise.
Dacquoise with a quack quack. You see? That just goes on, and then a little bit more cream.
Yeah.
And you guys are going to garnish it
up. Oh, yay. So we put more cream on the top?
Just to hold the strawberries together. Now, I have to say, when you make this, you should...
Can I put this on the top?
Yeah.
Is that all right?
Go for it. Exactly like that.
Can't you then use a knife to spread it? Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you, Tash.
No, exactly like that. That's perfect.
And look, I love how you're standing back. You're like, no, I can't bear this.
That looks amazing.
Doesn't it? And then we'll sprinkle some straws.
Yeah, you're covering up with strawberries anyway.
Yeah.
So it's better to always buy from us than make it. It'll be fine. Like, once we take the thing off, it's going to look beautiful.
Yeah, of course it will.
Can I ask a question? How much will one of these cost?
You know, this would cost about $60.
Wow.
Yeah. I've got a team of, I've got a team of 100 people making this cake. Mm. It is so popular.
And this is white chocolate?
That's right.
Oh, yummy.
Make it look like that one.
This rose, what is that? That's beautiful.
So, yeah, let's get these strawberries on.
So do we, can I sprinkle these?
Go for it.
Yeah?
So those rose petals also from Paria, and that is,
Is that enough?
What are these
chocolate pearls?
Chocolate pearls.
What are they?
So, all right.
Chocolate pearls.
Now let's see if we can get this off.
Oh.
Yeah, I know.
That's the...
Maybe not, huh?
Just let's see.
See, we should have used the saucepan lid.
Here it comes.
Oh, look, yes.
Oh, there we go.
Fabulous. Now, can we try it? Is that all right?
Yeah, look, obviously it's not set up, so we're going to go the old-fashioned way. Just go for it.
Is that, that's all right, just to
go for it, go for it.
And then, of course, our lovely audience can get a little sample. Come on, Tash, you're going to have to...
I've got to read this. The Smooth Festival of Chocolate is on next weekend at the Rocks in Sydney. Black Star Pastry will have, as Christopher mentioned, a stall set up, and he'll be doing a live demonstration of this incredible cake on the Sunday.
The Sunday.